So here it is, another episode of the Real Teacher Talk podcast with Mr. Nunez. All right, podcast about education, teaching, and hopefully some life experiences with our Anthony Clark, who's in the house. Say
yes,
what's up.
Sir. How y'all doing?
All right, so Anthony was a former, or is a former student. You were in eighth grade. How long ago?
2 years.
2 years?
Yeah.
2 years went by fast, huh, Anthony?
I was during the COVID.
Yeah, so then you used to sit in the back.
Oh, yeah, back of this classroom.
And just do what?
Nothing, just play games.
Oh, my goodness. Are you going to admit to that, Anthony?
Really? I did do work, but it wasn't like A effort. It was like C effort.
All right, there you go. At least you're being honest. You're being honest. And now how's it going?
It's kind of struggling, but I'm still getting there, you know. I'm not failing classes as much as I used to be.
Wow. Because?
Because I'm focusing in class.
There you go, because it's important, right?
Yeah, credits.
Yeah. All right, for a lot of these middle schoolers, right? High school gets a little tough. Yeah. But you could do it, right? It's possible.
It's possible if you put your mind to it.
Yay.
Sometimes you have distractions, but like, I'm not going to say it's so easy getting, like not get distracted.
Right.
But it's kind of hard. You know, right, it's easy too.
So what I'm going to bring to the table is, one, you're actually a skater, right?
Yeah.
And that's like a cool hobby to have. You probably... You know, got a bunch of stories. I hope you balance, you know, schoolwork with your hobby, which is skating and stuff, right? Which for anybody that's out there, that's important, right?
They
don't go out there skating till late at night and not do any assignments.
No, I get home around like 8.
Uh-huh.
Like on weekdays, if I go skate, I'm gonna skate near like my house.
Okay.
On weekends, I go to like Long Beach, downtown, Santa Monica. But like on weekends, that's when like I try to get my assignments done during the week,
uh-huh.
or try to. And if I don't, like, I try to do them in the mornings before I go out.
Okay, you know teachers are going to be listening to this, right?
Oh, yeah.
And they're gonna check you. They're like, oh, really?
Yeah,
so you better be telling the truth.
Sometimes.
There you go. At least he's being honest. Sometimes.
You know,
all right.
When it comes to the 12 a.m., the 12 midnight, you know, I'll be there. Especially tonight. You catch me there.
You'll catch you where? Doing assignments
during
at 12?
At 12
a.m. Oh, there you go. So give Anthony... Give Anthony a little extra time. Give him a 12:05 to turn in the assignment.
My Wi-Fi is slow. you know, sometimes my teachers be battling, man. I be battling for my spot in heaven sometimes, dude.
Why?
Because like I be like doing my work, and I get on TikTok, and I see a meme, and I laugh about it. And I go to the comments. It's like, oh, like it's all funny stuff. So I sit there for an hour thinking about the assignment.
So there you go. That's his distraction, TikTok.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure not just you. A bunch of kids are probably doing the same thing. They get on there and they get distracted. I'm sure teachers too. They get on their Pinterest, right?
Pinterest.
And then before you know it, they're like, "Oh damn!" You know, they're looking up stuff for their classrooms, or you know, because us teachers, we're kind of like into like you know improving our teaching and stuff. So we get a little distracted too with our Facebook and who knows what else. Hey, but listen, my understanding is you've been skating for a while. You're getting pretty good, right?
Yeah.
And you've actually got an opportunity to get sponsored by your brand, which is Mainline. Is that it?
Yeah, it's like Mainline is my homie's brand too.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
So, tell me a little bit for people that don't understand. Like when you get sponsored, like they hook you up with stuff, right?
So when you get sponsored, it's not like you're not guaranteed to get to the top, like pro, like Tony Hawk or anything.
Right.
So like, don't think, oh, I'm sponsored. I'm not that, because sometimes I see skaters, like they think they're cool. They're sponsored, right? But like some pro skaters I know, like I'm not like, oh, I know like what they did when they're 15. I'm not like that. Like I know them because they skate a lot, and I
uh-huh.
see them sometimes. And sometimes like I see like other fools like trying to like, I think it was Saturday too. There you go. It was Saturday. My homie Jeff was trying to do a staircase. It was like a pretty big one. It's up by it's by Little Tokyo. It's by LAPD station.
Right.
And because it's like a department. And what happened was he was trying to do it, but he was struggling. And so out of nowhere, these kids came out of nowhere, and they're like, they were saying, oh, I'm sponsored. I'm better than you, right? And they had like 600 followers. My
uh-huh.
boy has like a lot on Instagram. But he wasn't like bragging about it. He said, oh, like for sure, everyone's good. Everyone has their own levels, like for sure, right? He wasn't like
trying he's been humble.
Yeah,
he's been humble. That's good.
And so he tried to do his trick, focus on the trick, right? Because once you focus on something else, that trick is gone. Like you can say bye to that trick.
Wow.
And so,
that's real real talk, real important feedback for someone that's starting out. Like just focus on one, and then once you get that one, you move on to another one.
Yeah.
Oh.
Basically, like for me with my ollies, I got my ollies down. And I thought I was cool. You know, I thought I was like, oh, I'm going pro. But it doesn't work like that. Like, it took me like 4 weeks to get my ollies really high and really good nonstop. Yeah, I get them on lock. And some of these kids nowadays, they think they learn a kickflip and think they're God. And like, and then once you do one kickflip, like, they can't land it no more. Because they're not, it's not like on lock. You know, you uh-huh. have the tricks on lock. And what happened with Jeff was like, these kids are distracting him. He had cars coming. These people are walking by. So it was just like nonstop like, distractions.
Right.
And, you know, at one point we blocked off like a little part of the street uh-huh. with like the bike lane.
Uh-huh.
Block it off a little bit. So you can tell like cars won't like just like come in, just chill there because some cars do that. And what happened was these kids, they trying to attempt the stairs, which I give it to them, pretty big stairs.
Yeah.
You know, they attempted it. But my homie, like, he was like, nah, like, these kids see me trying to do this, you know, I'm like, he landed it, of course, he landed it, like, after, like, 50 tries. But, you know, it takes a lot of day, you know, like, it takes a lot of effort, a lot of, like, patience.
Getting hurt. Yeah. And then having to bounce back. Some dudes, I see they get hurt, and they go back, and they still
do it.
They like, go back. So it's like that fear of getting hurt, you have to put it in the back of your head and squash it so you can keep going. And try to make that trick happen, right?
Mm-hmm. And, you know, this guy is really good. He did it. And the kid tried to ollie it, but, like, he was very humble, but he's like, oh, like, he keep going, right? Kid lands it.
Huh.
He lands it ollie off of that big staircase. I got a video of it.
Cool.
And after that, we went home. We were like, oh, that's a nice skate sesh. Because I didn't skate that day. I was filming.
Right.
And so I was like, oh, like, I'm not going to skate because I got injured, too, on my uh-huh. leg, my right ankle. And well, it's not a big deal. It's like, oh, I broke it, but it was kind of, like, aching a little bit because, you know, I thought I was pro for a couple of tries on that staircase. I thought it was godlike.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, nah, like, when I landed on my leg, it's like my ankle went, like, it just went a different direction that day.
So you had to take it easy after that.
Yeah, I took it easy. I was like, I'll film. Don't trip.
Right.
But anyone could go pro. Anyone could.
If they stick to it.
They stick to it. They go for it. They, like, but at the same time, don't think you're going to go pro overnight. It's going to take a while.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Tony Hawk, he'd been skating since what?
Since he was, like, what, 7, 8? Younger than that, right?
Maybe older. I don't know. Cause like, but the thing is with Tony Hawk, though, he kept going.
Yeah.
Like, if you want to go pro, start younger.
Yeah.
Start younger. You know.
And be prepared to get hurt, right?
Yeah.
So who's your most famous skater that you've met or, you know, someone that you met that's actually a real, like, pro skater and stuff?
Jamie Foy.
Who's that?
He skates for Deathwish.
Okay.
He's pretty good. He's sponsored by Deathwish, all these brands.
Wow.
Even pro.
So you think that – so he's pretty much – pro, like him, that's his career. That's his job.
That's him, though.
So he's making money somewhere, somehow.
Like
off
Red
of,
Bull. Like, all these brands are just sponsoring him.
Wow.
And
he competes professionally.
Yeah, he competes around, like, bigger, like, competitions than, like, these little, like, skate park ones.
Uh-huh.
He competes more than other, like, those bigger, like, X Games, maybe, I think he did.
Okay.
And, like, Naja Houston.
Oh, yeah.
That guy, too. He's really good.
Okay. So those are his homies.
So they're like his, like, you know, his best friends.
Wow.
They skate together. I was like, damn.
Imagine that. And that could be you, Anthony Clark.
Yeah, one day.
That is going to be you, Anthony Clark.
Yeah,
one day. I want to be the one to say, hey, I interviewed Anthony Clark before he turned pro.
Yeah, like, I'm trying to, like, right now, I've been doing my schoolwork. No, I'm trying to do my schoolwork.
Yeah, just graduate. Yeah. Hey, graduate, get into school, go to college, but still skate. You're going to meet people that are probably, when you go to college, that are into skating, into videotaping, right? But at the same time, you know, have that college in your back pocket so you can say, okay, I can still skate and do something else.
Like, maybe, like, I don't think the college would be the best opportunity for me.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I may join the military most likely.
Oh, okay. That's an option, too, for a lot of people, right? Yeah. Who knows? Maybe they have a skate team for the imagine if they had a skate team for the military.
I would join the military. I would join right now.
No, I don't think that.
I'll be like, come on, bro.
Sponsored by the Army. No.
Sponsored, honestly. Imagine that'd be your biggest flex. Sponsored by the U.S. military. The U.S.
biggest flex.
Me.
I don't think they're rolling into. I don't think they have a skate team rolling in, taking over countries with the.
The
skateboards and stuff.
Instead of like you run up with them.
Yeah.
He did a skateboard.
That's funny. But that's cool, Anthony, man. Hey, well, again, this is something for the school. This is something for MaCES, something for students. And, hey, I think you gave them some advice and stuff. Anything else you want to add to the convo before we shut it down? As far as what? Like skating, anything like...
Have a good day.
How do you have a good day? Like, how do you know you had a good day?
Like, oh, that's a hard question. Even I don't know if I had a good day.
Yeah, even if you landed all your tricks, you don't even know if you had a good day.
Yeah, you can't tell because, like, imagine, like, how much effort you put in that trick. You're drained.
You're drained?
Yeah, like, you're tired. Like, you're done. You want to give up.
You want to give up. You go home. You rest up. And then you come back again.
I think having a good day for me doesn't exist. It's just kind of like having to just have a day, you know?
Yeah.
It wasn't too bad, like someone yelling at you, someone trying to start a problem with you.
Oh, that's right. You were talking about how sometimes they come at you, all the Karens, the Kens, and the security guards. Dude, that's another conversation, right?
But next time, yeah, because sometimes these dudes, they get out of pocket. I promise. I'd be like, what my homie doing? Like, all right, it'd be a last story. It'd be like a few seconds.
Actually. Go ahead.
All right, we skated Little Tokyo. There's a force there. And it's like it's skate stopped already. Like it has like these speed bumps.
Uh huh.
But it doesn't stop it because it's really small. So I tried to do it. My friend started to do it. So my homie, Caleb, he did it. He lands it.
Okay.
God. And after these cops, not like these security. They had a gun, but they were security.
Oh, okay. Armed security. Yeah.
Armed security. Yeah. I thought they were cops. Uh huh. But they started flashing their lights, their flashlights and stuff. Uh huh. And they were saying, like, oh, get off the boards. Like, can you not read? Because I had a big sign saying no skateboarding, uh-huh. no bicycling, no, like, rollerblading, I guess.
Right.
And, oh, no, literally, like, it's like that sign all the time. Every place has a sign on trespassing and stuff. And they were saying, like, can you not read? Like, what's wrong with you? Or are you dumb? Like, are you this? But they I'm censoring the words. They said rougher words.
Wow.
And so, he was an old guy, too. He wasn't old, but he was old.
Huh.
He's, like, your age.
Damn, like you just older. Called me old.
But older.
You like, said old, but not old, but your age. You like, just called me old.
Like, he looks like you, but way older, like gray.
All right, hair, I got you. Okay, man, I get it. I understand what you're saying. Go ahead, right, tell the story. Right. No, I'm all just right. kidding.
After they tried to take his board, and dude, like, he said, nah, like, get away from me. It's my property. Like, you can't do this. I understand. I'll leave. Like, don't
trip. They put hands on him, basically, right?
They're trying to take his board.
Uh-huh.
And, like, it got out of pocket real fast. Like, I'm there, like, sitting on the ledge. So uh-huh. I was not getting involved, you know? I'm not trying to get a ticket.
Yeah.
So basically, I was kind of, like, not obeying, too, because I was trying it, too. So,
yeah.
Basically, I can't get involved with that because it'll make my case even worse.
Yeah, I hear you.
So, I was like, oh, like, let's just go already. Let's pack up. We're done here. Because there's a Starbucks right next to it. So, let's go to Starbucks. Let's go. There's a safe spot. And they were saying, nah, like, we could call the cops. We could give you a ticket. Oh, this could be a fine. You could get, like, ego or juvie and stuff.
Uh-huh.
So my homie, one of the dudes slapped him with a board.
Oh, that's extra right that there, man. Extra. Now you just took it to a felony now. Why are you doing that?
Right? And dude,
or to assault or something. Not a felony, but.
But basically, it's like assault and battery because basically what he used was kind of like it was used as a weapon.
Right.
And so, like, he dipped, bro. Everyone just dipped. And I'm there, like, on my phone playing Clash Royale.
Uh-huh.
Because I'm still stuck in Spooky Town. Till right. this day.
Yeah.
So I'm still stuck.
What do you mean you're still stuck?
I'm still stuck in that arena, bro. Like, I haven't gotten out of there.
I don't know what that means, but go on. Tell this.
And then they were questioning me, like, saying, like, they were saying that I was involved.
What?
But even though I wasn't, like, in the argument, you know, I was just on my phone, like, my own business. But I guess, they were saying, like, I could be, like,
an accessory or something. Accessory
to it. And then I was like, oh, I'll just dip out then, peace. Like, I don't know what happened.
Yeah.
And so, like, I skated away. I see him two blocks down. I see all my movies two blocks down eating, bro. They're eating like the slice of pizza off by.
So they weren't cops. They were just part of the security team. Part of the security team.
But like they said they called them and they're just there eating, you know? Like, uh-huh. He didn't care. Like, that's not their problem.
Oh, you said the cops, LAPD cops or somebody else?
Like LAPD cops. They're like, their cars were just parked there.
And oh,
like,
I see.
They're like just like over the hood eating.
Yeah.
And like they just didn't care. They just. Eight right there.
Yeah. All right. So you got lucky, man. So my suggestion next time, get out of there before it escalates.
Before I didn't think he was going to do that.
Yeah. But see, you got to watch who you hang out with because the people that you hang out with right? And this is for everybody. Sometimes those are the ones that get you in trouble.
Especially sometimes they, you know, you don't know they're evolving.
Yeah.
And so, like, you could, like, get, like, say they did something and they could blame you and that you weren't there.
Ooh.
So, like, say you were there, but you didn't do, like, say someone, like, robs or something. Like, say your friend robs someone or stole a bike. And, like, you didn't take it.
You're because you're associated,
You didn't stop it. You didn't put no effort in it. And they're,
but you tried to, like, get them to leave. Out, you know, like, try to, hey, let's just go, but they didn't listen, so.
Nah, because they were trying to take the board.
Yeah, but still, though, when you start swinging them, that's now, like you said, assault and battery.
Mm-hmm. Even though it's not a weapon, it was considered as a weapon.
Look at that. Yeah. So now you know better, right? And that goes for anybody else. Watch how you hang out with, right?
Yeah, sometimes, you know, like, you may think your homies are cool. You may think they got your back.
But they, like, make mistakes.
They make mistakes, too. So everyone makes mistakes. We're not perfect.
Yeah, but when you go out there in the streets after hours, you know, you just got to know that you got to play by the rules. And if they ask you to leave, leave.
Leave, dude. Right? Like, don't. I mean, some security officers are cool. Like, you'd be like, crap, one more try, I'll dip out.
Yeah.
Then you get the one more try.
Like, yeah.
Most times, I get one more try of it.
Okay.
Because, like, I give them my word. And I'm like, oh, I'll dip out, I promise. Uh-huh. Okay, if I fail, we come back, like, 2 hours later. And do it again.
What happened to, like, dipping after your last try?
I mean, I did for 2 hours. I mean,
okay. I don't know about that one. All right.
Maybe 2 minutes.
Okay, man. Well, hey, Anthony, I think we did a pretty good job of, you know, bringing the skate world to MaCES.
Honestly.
All right.
Come on, so, MaCES. Sponsor me. I'll skate that.
No, you're not. Nope, nope. See, he's not supposed to be. Nope, he's not supposed to be skating on campus.
No,
I'm gonna tell you right now. I do not condone him skating on campus. I'm the one that's always telling him get off the skateboard. I'm just letting you know. I'm the one.
I think MaCES should start, like, a skating little.
Ooh, a skating team.
Yeah, like, they should have a little area.
You could start a skating club, and then y'all could meet somewhere, and y'all could be skating, and then that could be your little skate sponsorship,
I think, like, maybe, like, blacktops. I feel like, you know, blacktops is very wide and stuff.
I don't think you could skate. Well, I don't know. You could play football. You could do all kinds of stuff here. I mean, why not skate?
Like, maybe anyway. Just, like, not skate, like, obstacles, like the staircase.
You're not jumping the obstacles. That's not happening.
One day when I go pro.
That's not happening. All right, there you go. When you go pro, you're going to come and bring it back to MaCES. Yes. All right, man.
Peace out,
we'll
MaCES.
Cut it out. Peace out, MaCES. Thank you for looking at the Real Teacher Talk podcast with Mr. Nunez. Peace.
Peace.